Okay, here we are in Cobalt Strike. What I'd like to show you now is how to turn a USB thumb drive or a CD-ROM into an attack vector with Cobalt Strike. First, go to Attacks, Packages, USB CD AutoPlay. Okay? What this dialog does is it will generate a auto run inf file to add an autoplay action when the USB thumb drive is opened up, okay? And if the user takes the action we desire them to take, it will give us a session on their host. Let's go ahead and take a look at this. First, I'd like to give you some background on just how autoplay works. If we go to Start, My Computer, Windows determines what to show you when you open up a thumb drive based on its contents, okay? Right now, this drive is empty, so when I right-click and do autoplay, nothing happens, okay? However, if I copy some pictures over, let's go ahead and do that now, and I go ahead and right-click and go to autoplay, we now have some options, okay? First, Windows is telling us that this is a device with pictures. That sounds kind of innocuous. And there's this nice open folder to view files action, okay? Something that's really interesting is several years ago, the Configure Worm created an action using the auto run inf file that looked just like this open folder to view files action. And that's what Cobalt Strike is set up to emulate by default, okay? First, we're going to give our drive a label. In this case, we'll do wedding photos. It fits the theme. And to emulate the actions of Configure, we're going to create an autoplay action called open folder to view files. And for the icon, we're going to reference a file that is located on the user's system. System32 shell32.dll icon number 5, because the index starts at 0. If you want to see what the icon that is, let's go take a look. I'm going to use a program called IcoFX. Let's go ahead and close that. File open. C Windows System32 shell32.dll. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we are. This is the icon that will be shown. You'll notice that looks pretty similar to the icon next to our autoplay action for the thumb drive. In fact, it is the same icon. See? And this is what Cobalt Strike is set up to use by default. Now what you can do is if there's another icon or another kind of drive you want to emulate, take a look at all these different options and consider using them in your social engineering attack. Now let's go back to making a USB thumb drive into an attack vector. You're welcome to change this autoplay icon to whatever you like, use a different index if you choose, or place an icon on the thumb drive and just put the icon file name right here. It doesn't really matter. All we really need to do to make this attack work is come up with an executable. Fortunately, Cobalt Strike makes that easy to generate. Just go to Attacks, Packages, Windows executable. Here I've got to choose which host to connect back to. That's correct by default. If I don't have a listener, I need to add one. But since everything looks okay, I'm going to go ahead and press Generate. And let's give this file an innocuous name that fits our theme. We'll call it photoviewer.exe. Now let's go ahead and add that to our USB CD autoplay package. Go ahead and select that, and let's press Launch. Cobalt Strike is going to ask us where to save these autoplay files to. The place that makes most sense is to save them directly to the thumb drive. So I'm going to select the thumb drive, press Open, and there we go. Cobalt Strike has now created an auto run inf file in the E drive. Okay, Now, let's look at this from the victim's perspective. Here we are on the victim device, okay? And I plugged the USB thumb drive in, and you can see that the first and default action is open folder to view files from this wedding photos USB thumb drive. Now, the real option is way down here, but somebody's not paying attention, might just press OK. Here we are on the attack system, and we have a session. Let's go ahead and right-click, Meterpreter, explore screenshot. And there you go. That's how you turn a USB thumb drive into an attack using Cobalt Strike.